Hey everybody, I'm doing this as a video for a group, you know, all of my youngins, and when I say my youngins, I mean nine head, but this video here is going for all my youngins and their other halves, for those that have the other halves. I guess the only exception would be William, because he's not available for anything, so therefore this video isn't intended towards him, or for him rather. I'll try to make it as short as possible, but it may be a little long. I do hope that all of you will at least watch it entirely. Originally, I started typing a text to send out to all of you in a group text, but it turned out to be super, super long. For those of you that don't know, sometimes when I get to writing things down, I end up writing a book, as some people refer to it as. Sorry for the shakiness. On the dirt road, I just left the house. I'll be on the paved road here shortly, so the shakiness won't be as bad. But I'm headed to Reesville. I got a doctor's appointment this morning. Most all of you probably don't even know, but I'm fixing to have a second neck surgery coming up, possibly next month in January of 2020. And also sometime soon, supposed to have happened already, but it hadn't happened. And what I'm talking about now is supposed to be getting can't think of what it's called right now. I'm having a brain fart, but I'm supposed to be getting those, electro things put in my back on my spine, to help reduce my back pain. Public, so anybody can't just go and watch it. I send you the link to it, you share that link with somebody else, then that person can go watch it. Anybody that's got the link to the video can watch it. But without the link, of course, you can't find it and watch the video. But, so, like I said, I know that Amber and William have never even watched the videos that I made for them and sent to them. So, I just realized I got to get gas before I head out of town. I'm running behind already. But, so I may pause this video, and it may be a two-part video, but I'll piece it together if that's the case, because I'm fixing to have to go to a gas station to get me some gas. So I'll stop the video during that time. But, back to the main subject is me doing Santa Claus. Now, just to give you a rundown of me doing Santa Claus in general, is that back in 2015, I officially retired from military in June of 2015, which gave me 25 and a half years in service, and then went back to work with the city. Unfortunately, didn't go back to police work because of medical reasons, and they put me back to work, or put me to work with the street department. November or sometime getting close to December, the sheriff's department, because I've been letting my beard grow out, the sheriff's department got in touch with me and asked me if I would do Santa for their annual Christmas party. At first I was like, I don't want to do that, because I've never really had any interest in doing Santa Claus. But after thinking over it a little bit, I thought, okay, what the heck, I'll do it for them. So I agreed to do Santa Claus for them for their Christmas party that year of 2015. Of course, I didn't have a Santa Claus suit, but they told me they had one that wasn't theirs, but they could get a hold of one for me to use to dress up as Santa. Well, me, I want to do things to be authentic as possible. So, they provided the suit, which turned out it was one of the real super cheap Walmart type deals, or one that you used to get at Walmart, like 20-something, 30-something dollar suit at the most, and it's just real cheap, crappy suit, but it's something a person can throw on, give kids the appearance of being Santa Claus. And so that's what I had to work with that year. But wanting to look more authentic, I went and had my beard bleached and paid money out of my pocket for that, because there was not going to be any pay for doing the sheriff's department Christmas party. It was just something I was doing for them for free as a favor to them. And anyhow, I paid money out of my pocket, got my bleached beard so it could be white or close to it, and then I didn't have any hair on my head, still skint from like military, and so I had to wear the wig. And even looking back at the pictures, I can see how goofy and unmatched it was to have my bleached beard, natural beard, but having to use old fake weird wig. Anyhow, I'm gonna pause this video for now, or stop the video, and I'll get back, pause it. Let's see, it's thank you. Let me pause it and then restart it. Okay. Dang it. Damn. Alright, try this again. It did let me pause the recording and restart it. That's just like a while ago, and the gas nozzle kept cutting off on me. I had to get back out and restart it. Anyhow, so while I'm waiting on the gas to pump a little bit, I figure I'd talk another minute or two. So back to the thing about doing the Santa Claus for the Jeff Davis Sheriff's Department. I did that year, and at the same time, I got to do, I had two stores in town in, here in Hazelhurst that I was able to do. One was for Sheila. I don't know if any of y'all remember, but Sheila and one of her friends from work that year was trying to have their own store on the side outside of their, you know, full-time job. And they made a little profit, but overall they lost money, so they had to shut down after 2 or 3 months of operation. But I did Santa one day for them at their store, trying to bring in some customers, which it brought some folks in. I don't know if they made any sales, but another day separate from that same year, they had a little department type store right around the corner from them, and that lady offered to pay me to do Santa for her for a couple of hours, and I did. And during that time also, I think I told all of y'all about it, and only Haley at the time was able to stop by, and she brought little baby Scarlett, and got a couple pictures of little baby Scarlett with Santa that year. Being such a tiny infant, she wasn't scared of Santa Claus then. But let me pause this again. Okay, here we go one more time. We're off and I'm leaving the station. Murphy's here at Walmart in Hazelhurst, and now I'm on my way headed to Reesville for my doctor's appointment. So like I was saying, Haley got to bring Scarlett that year. Visit Santa 2015, me wearing that cheap old flimsy crappy old Santa suit that year, and having to wear a wig because I had no head hair. So it, even though I bleached my beard, it just was not an authentic look. But overall, you know, that's the only three things I did that year as Santa, and only one of them was a paid thing. But I wasn't really doing it for the pay. I was just doing it, you know, starting off as doing the Sheriff's Department a favor, and helping out Sheila at her store. And but anyhow, overall, I enjoyed doing it. I enjoyed seeing all the happy, smiling faces of the kids that did get to come see Santa, and I really enjoyed getting to see the young kids' faces light up the way they do whenever they first walk around the corner or whatever the case may be, and they first see Santa, and their faces just light up with cheer and happiness, and I really enjoyed that. After that, I decided that I want to do Santa every year for anybody in any place that wants Santa. I'll gladly do it if I'm able. But I also said that I want to be more authentic looking. I want to look more like the real Santa is portrayed in pictures. But at the same time, I've always liked the old world classic type of look instead of what is most commonly used by some. And so I wanted to have a more authentic classical or classic type of Santa Claus look. So after December that year, I said I'm going to start letting my hair grow so that way I can use my real hair on my head and my real beard. And of course my hair is not white and beard is not white, so I knew I was going to have to bleach it all. But I also told myself that after that year, I'm not going to bleach my beard again because it just destroyed my beard. My head hair, I'm not worried about it because I feel, you know, once Christmas is over, I can get the shears and just shy that way. Sometimes when I'm in more of a hurry and don't have more than 2 hours to get ready, I have to take a hair dryer to my hair with the curlers in it to help get my hair dry that much faster, and that works. But most of the time I'll take, like if I got something around lunchtime or so, that morning when I get up, I'll go ahead and do my hair and get the curlers in it. And so while I'm just fiddling or doing other stuff around the house, my hair can be drying. That way an hour or an hour and a half away from my time to be there, or at least time to leave the house, I'll start actually getting ready with the makeup and the suit and everything, put that on. So it takes me some time to get ready and get transformed. If it didn't take so much time, if it was just as easy as throwing on the suit and go, then yeah, I could do that in 10 minutes. I could just go do anything as Santa anywhere real quick. I could even just come to each of you individually and do Santa for the grandkids at y'all's house individually. I've had that thought of doing that, but that would require a lot more work and time for me to do it individually, unless I went the same day. I just don't remember. But I do remember at some point, whether it be 2016, 2017, that, you know, I said to myself, you know, I'm doing Santa, and so I should do it for all of my grandkids. It's something I would enjoy doing, having pictures of me being Santa for all the grandkids. To have that memory of it, have pictures that they could look back on when they get older, and at that point would know that, hey, it's me, Papa Mike, being Santa Claus for them when they were little kids. And so that's why 2017, I know we got together and did their dog in the road. We did a little get together for all the kids to come over and see Santa, and we did it at our house. So, of course, Amber and William didn't bring Jackson. But all the rest of you did. Y'all come over, got to visit. You know, we used the gifts that Sheila and I got for all the grandkids as the gifts they received from Santa. And got pictures, and all of them got to see Santa, and I got to see the smiling faces as they get to see Santa. Except for a couple, if I remember correctly, little Scarlett and Ansley. Care for Santa at the time too much, especially little shy Scarlet. But yeah, they did at least get to see Santa. But part of my thinking on that is doing Santa for them is that I know, especially with life being busy, all of you don't have the time to try and take the kids to some location where Santa's at, so kids can go visit Santa. Some places, especially like malls, those mall Santas, to take your kids to see a mall Santa, usually, I think in most places, they charge you to go see Santa. But overall, whether you're having to pay for the kids to see Santa or not, doesn't have time to take the kids to see Santa. I remember when most of y'all were little, didn't have time or get the opportunity to take y'all to go see Santa. With the exception of, you know, Blake, Kimmy, and Nash, didn't get to be in their real young life. Well, it was with Kimmy. Back then when the rest of you were real little, I don't remember ever getting the chance to take y'all to see Santa. And so, on Christmas Eve, usually if Papa Bernie was available, Papa Bernie, however you want to call him, went and bought one of those old cheap flimsy Walmart Santa suits and gave it to him. And so each Christmas, one night, I think usually before Christmas Eve, we would give him the present that was for each of you, and he would come over and play Santa for a few minutes that night of Christmas Eve. He'd stop by playing Santa and be Santa for y'all, which at the time y'all didn't know it was him, but y'all thought, hey, Santa Claus is coming to see us, giving us a gift. So all of y'all got to enjoy that. Well, that's, you know, for those of you that are able and even prefer to take, you know, grandkids to go see some fake mall Santa or some other Santa at some there, he's not showing up. And if I come out of my bedroom as Santa, you know, they can easily catch on more that it's me. I prefer that they don't know it's me. You know, later as they get older, then okay, then they can know it's me doing Santa for them. But while they're all really young and little like this, I prefer that they don't know it's me. I got from it, and started doing Santa Claus, I started trying to train the mustache to take that curl. So when I am Santa Claus, it's, I got that curl on the tips of the mustache. But, I know this is getting to be a lot longer than what I intended it to be. I thought this, I could do a little video and, to all of y'all to get my point across and make it quicker than you having to read a super long text or short book. Plus, I figure I can easier get my point across to all of you. There's one thing about texting. I don't mind texting, you know, for a short, brief message or two, but when it comes to your own conversation, I don't want to text. I've even told y'all, don't text me a conversation. I'd rather call you on the phone, talk to you on the phone, if not in person. Because over the phone, or in person, you can see a person's facial expressions in person, you know, or video chat. And if it's, even if it's just over the phone, you can hear a person's tone of their voice, and you can get a better understanding of what's being said from the person that way. Whereas it comes through a text, you're just reading words, and you can't. A person just reading words can't get the full personal impression that a person is trying to get across from just reading words. And often, many, many times, what I'm saying has been misinterpreted. Not just through y'all, but through many people, you know, in the past, whether it be an email I sent or text or whatever the case may be. I've been misinterpreted many times from some what I'm trying to say in my writing, because people can't see my facial expressions, they can't hear the tone of my voice, so I'm often misinterpreted in what I'm saying. That's why I'd rather talk on the phone. When you're talking on the phone, everybody can say what they gotta say, get the message across a lot quicker and easier by carrying on a conversation through the phone rather than through a text. Get it done a lot quicker, easier, much more full understanding of what's being said by each person. Plus, many a time, if I'm busy doing something, I ain't got time to keep stopping to send a text. I'd rather. Many a time when I'm busy doing something and somebody, not saying necessarily y'all, but just anybody, could send me a text and I'm like, dang, you know, I had to stop what I'm doing, pull my phone out, look at the text. There's even times whenever I didn't catch the text, you know, until a couple hours later because I'm not too busy doing something, running machines or some kind of noise. I don't know if my phone went off until later when I happen to look at my phone. But that's why I like to conversate better, and that's another reason I want to do this video, so that maybe y'all could get a better understanding of what I'm saying without any misinterpretation, any hurt feelings or getting upset with me because of something I'm saying. That definitely is not my intent. I don't want to hurt any of y'all's feelings. I don't want to make any of y'all upset with me. And of course, as y'all, you know, I got this nasty habit, so you just have to overlook me as I'm doing my dip and stuff like that. But, overall, I'd love to do Santa for y'all. I prefer it not be at my house. Like I said, I talked to all of you and asked y'all to work together, or most all of you, to work together, contact each other, and grandkids this year. And I don't know if any of y'all really did do that, but Haley had mentioned it to me a couple of times that were asking me about it, and at one point it was just her texting me. I mentioned to her again about how I wanted y'all to talk amongst each other to work something out. So I think she took it upon herself to, you know, contact each of you, or most each of you, all of you, to try to work something out. Transformed into about 600 and something bucks. Like, I ain't got that kind of money to spare to put on just a pair of boots. It cost more than my darn suit did. But, so I just went with my black boots and black belt. But I do want to, you know, get boots or use boots that look like the old world style brown leather to go with the suit. So come next year, I'm gonna have some. I mean, I did try to take an old pair of my slip-on work boots to and took those brown leather slip-over things, and I tried to, you know, glue and secure those to the old slip-on work boots I have, and you know, they work, it stays in place, so it looks like an actual boot instead of just a slip-on thing, but it don't look as good because it's got so much extra bulkiness right there at the instep of the foot area. Just don't look good. Just really don't look like a real boot, in my opinion. Now, kids, I'm sure wouldn't even notice it for the most part, unless they were real older kids. But, yeah, I did that. I may try to use them tomorrow. Because tomorrow, Friday, the 20th, I have two Santa events to do. One tomorrow morning at R&D, and one tomorrow afternoon at the Hazelhurst Jeff Davis Housing Authority, and then Saturday night I got the Sheriff's Department's Christmas party to do. Like Haley had suggested that to do the Santa visit at our house Saturday around lunchtime, which wouldn't work for me because I have other things going on during the day that I need to take care of, and then shortly around or after lunch, you know, mid-afternoon, I got to start getting ready as Santa, you know, do my hair while I'm trying to take care of other things, and then a couple hours prior to having to be there for the Sheriff's Department party is when I'll actually get the makeup on and get the full dress up and look as Santa Claus. But so currently I have those three events that I got to do Santa for. And that's all I have left, you know, as far as currently booked or scheduled for this year of 2019 as Santa. Something else may come up, but I doubt it. You know, just late in the ball game, I don't think there's going to be any other events come up where somebody needs me as Santa. But if it does, then if I can do it, I'll do it. But, so basically, Santa for Saturday, this coming Saturday, would not be good for me. Just, it would be too much for me to try to do it Saturday. But, like I mentioned a while ago, I'll be doing R&D tomorrow. I'll be at R&D Auto there off Baxley Highway. Tomorrow morning, Friday, from 10 to 12. If some of you are able and want to bring grandkids by then, you don't have to pay. They're doing it, you know, as advertisement, trying to get people in to buy and stuff like that. But of course, you ain't got to go buy anything. You got to pay to come in. But if you're able and you want to bring the kids by then, they can come see Santa, me, at that time. Between 10 and 12 at R&D tomorrow. As far as the housing authority, that's supposed to be just for those kids where their parents live within the government housing area. So I wouldn't suggest you come by during that time, because then they may question, well, hey, you don't live here. But anyhow, I'm sure they wouldn't run you off if you did come by the housing authority, but I'm doing that tomorrow afternoon. And then, of course, the Saturday night, that's the sheriff's department. But, so, an opportunity that you could bring kids by would be tomorrow morning, 10 to 12 at R&D Auto, off the back of the highway. But other than that, my available times that I could do it for everybody to get together would be, you know, maybe Sunday evening. I could do it for everybody as a group to come with the kids. And when I do it, I prefer it to be, like I said previously, you know, just a short visit. Like last year when we did it at Nick and Brittany's, you know, Santa showed up at their house, you know, did a quick visit, and then Santa had to leave. That way less chance of them to, you know, put it all together that, hey, it's me, Papa Mike is Santa Claus. So I prefer it to be a short visit for the kids. And like if it's done at my house, you know, I can't sit there and, you know, hey, quick visit, and then I go change out, because heck, I have to get a shower to get all that stuff washed off anyhow. But it's time for me to be in there for my doctor's appointment right now. Just to make this short, I'm sitting here looking at the time. Shoot, I done went over an hour recording this. Jeez, I hate that it's that long. But I hope y'all all take the time to watch this and, you know, understand me and my point across a little better. But again, there's tomorrow morning, 10 to 12 at R&D. Another option would be for everybody to come as one group would be Sunday evening. Then there's Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday, which is Christmas Eve. I prefer it to be in the evening, you know, when it's, you know, dark or getting dark, but it don't have to be. And I prefer it to be, you know, somebody else's house or some other location other than our house. It's just, I prefer it that way. That way Santa shows up, does his visit, and he leaves. So any of those times, if y'all let me know. Like I said, y'all can see this video, and then y'all can maybe talk amongst each other. And if you can show up for a Santa visit, great. And if you can't because you're too busy or you done did a Santa visit somewhere else, then okay, I understand. Completely do understand. I just wish it could happen, but if it can't happen, then okay, maybe next year. But so there's tomorrow morning, Friday, 10 to 12 at R&D, sometime Sunday evening, Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday. But if y'all can't work it out and don't want to, then that's fine, or not able, not that you don't want to. So that's when I'm available. That's when I can do it. And maybe we can work something out. But if not, let me know if you can't, and so I can know when I'll be doing it. Because as soon as I know when my last time as Santa is over with, even if it's Christmas Eve, but just as soon as I know it's over with, when I go to wash up and get cleaned up from being that last Santa event, all this hair is coming off. It's going to come off and then start growing out its natural color again. And then the mustache is going back down too. Anyhow, I love all of you. I hope y'all will let me know something soon.